Hello, Julian Lennon.
Hi.
we had a bit from a private video by John Lennon, which portrayed him as very much like a family man.
Hmm.
Being his son, was he?
Well, he did start to get that way later on. You know, he liked cooking and running around the house. And he liked making bread a lot, honey bread and pancakes. So, yeah, later on, yeah.
Very healthy.
Sometimes.
He was also a very musical man. I know that you were apart from him for quite many years, but did he bring you up in a musical way?
Well, I mean, we used to jam around a lot, you know, on guitars, but that was whenever he felt like it, or I asked him, why don't we sit down? But not really.
He didn't teach you to play any instrument?
Well, I mean, with the guitar, just a couple of chords now and then with some rock and roll songs, but nothing more than that.
So you chose the piano instead?
Well, later on, yeah.
Are you able to press that middle button down on the tape recorder over there?
The middle one?
Yeah.
Why?
I want to play something for you.
The middle one?
Yes, that one.
Okay, there's that.
There we go.
1, 2, 3, 4.
I haven't heard this for ages.
Okay, you can start.
God, blimey.
Do you remember?
Yeah.
How old were you?
About 11, I think.
11 years old?
10 or 11.
It was you playing the drums and your father
trying
singing.
Trying to play the drums, yeah.
You're trying to play the drums. Yeah. And you forgot all about that and picked the piano later.
Well, I mean, I've tried many instruments throughout, you know, my life so far. You know, I mean, it's good to have a variety that you can play rather than sticking to one thing. So, yeah, I mean, I'll play anything that I can get my hands on.
Do you play the drums as well now as you did that time?
Well, a little bit better.
A little bit better, okay. Your LP, The Lot, is quite an extraordinary LP for an 84 LP. The sound and the texture, it was Phil Ramone who did it, but you seem to have picked quite another, not a very modern sound as such. It's more like a double fantasy sound.
Well, I mean, the actual LP was, the influences that I used or in the old days. I mean, like groups like Steely Dan and Keith Jarrett, as well as the Beatles. I mean, there's many bands I listen to, which are generally from the late 60s, 70s. I've never really been interested in the modern side of music, you could say. So, it was basically because of those influences and because I like that style of music much more than today's.
It's not punk or
it's definitely not punk.
And it's not very synthesized rock.
No.
Did you listen a lot to Beatles when you were young?
Well, I started listening to them again when I was about 15, you know, started really listening to the songs, but... I mean, not before that. I was too young, you know.
Do you like it now?
Yeah, sure. I mean, they're incredible songwriters, you know.
Being the son of John Lennon, there must have been a lot of disadvantages connected to that.
Well, I mean, the main ones which started off were the comparisons. Too many of them, you know. I mean, it almost got to the stage where I picked my nose the same as my father does, you know, which is too much, you know. But, I mean, that's the real burden, you could say, with all the critics and the press. But, hopefully, after a while, it'll settle down and go away after the next album or something like that.
And what was the advantages?
Meeting a lot of musicians in the business and... learning a lot of knowledge from them about the business, that's the real advantage.
Yeah, on your LP, you've worked with a lot of studio...
Session guys.
Session musicians. What was that like? I mean, you were young.
No, well, I mean... when I used to go to the studio with my dad, I mean, he used to have session guys with, and I met a lot of them, and I got on really well with the guys that had known about music for a long time. So I mean, this like another chance of being able to, well, in this case, it was me that was working with them. It felt really good because I got on really well with them.
I read in the paper that perhaps you were going to do something with Paul McCartney.
Did you?
I did.
Well, I mean, you never know. I mean, perhaps I might do something with Jackson one day, but, you never know. I don't know.
But there are no plans?
No, not yet. No.
Not even plans for a next LP, perhaps?
Oh, yeah, definitely plans for that, but nothing confirmed yet.